My wife and I are getting ready to attend a vigil at the Spokane Tribal Gathering Place and stand with our community against racism. If you've ever believed racism is a thing of the past, take a look at Charlottesville, Virginia, right now, online, and see hundreds of people chanting Nazi slogans in the streets. Many of these people call themselves Christians. As a Christian, it is my responsibility to give voice to the truth of Jesus Christ, who is love available to all. In case there's any doubt that the Bible condemns racism, a few points. One, Moses married a black woman. His sister was so offended by that, she openly questioned his authority as leader of Israel. God's response? It caused her to become white as snow from leprosy. Almost as if to say, you're proud of your fair skin? How about now? Second, while the Jews were to keep themselves separate from the Gentiles, the division was between those who wanted to follow God and those who don't. It was not who was a descendant of Abraham and who wasn't. When it became popular to think that lineage or cultural heritage was some sort of advantage before God, John the Baptist came and said, God could make a son of Abraham out of a stone. Your race does not make you superior. Even Peter, St. Peter, struggled with racism. It wasn't until God gave him a special vision that he was able to witness non-Jews receiving the same Holy Spirit he received at Pentecost. There are several New Testament warnings not to show partiality. As a Christian, I do not have the right nor the justification not to speak up. Proverbs 30 says, open your mouth for the mute, for the rights of all the unfortunate. Open your mouth to judge righteously and defend the rights of the afflicted and needy. Jeremiah 22, verse 3 says, thus says the Lord, do justice and righteousness and deliver the one who has been robbed from the power of his oppressor. Isaiah 1, 17, learn to do good, seek justice, reprove the ruthless. There were ruthless people in the streets of Charlottesville, Virginia. People who have murdered others. They must be reproved. There are people in our Spokane community who sympathize with those neo-Nazis and share their beliefs. They must be reproved. We must seek justice. These things can't all be done at home on the couch. Now, I don't claim to have all the answers. I'm still learning to do good. But as a Christian, I must do my part. Jesus followers, your part right now is to call racism out for what it is. It's evil. Our community needs to see that when so-called Christians promote hate, lovers of Jesus will stand up and say, no, Jesus is about God's love for everyone. We need to overcome evil with good. Even if you can't come stand with us this evening, say something. Put it on your Facebook, Twitter, Instagram, whatever. Talk about it with your friends and be specific. Don't just say flowery things about peace, love, and unity. No, say those white supremacists in Charlottesville, Virginia do not represent me. As a Christian, I denounce racism as evil and anti-Christ. Trust me, people are listening. Join us.